Last season, St. Bonaventure cruised to a 31-6 win over Channel Islands. Let's see how this year's game turned out. Well, Channel Islands matching their point total of last year in the first quarter. Tommy Manga, 1-yard touchdown. Still in the first quarter, the option. Lorenzo Booker takes it upfield. End of the first quarter, Channel Islands up 6-0 now. First play of the second quarter, fourth and goal. St. Bonaventure goes for it. Michael Spargo to Brandon Mascori, the touchdown. The conversion failed, 6-6. Second quarter, Lorenzo Booker. He's only a sophomore, Jerry. 31 yards. I had trouble finding my classes as a sophomore. This guy's running for 31 yards. And then more Booker. A couple yards for the touchdown. And it's 12, pretty much the two-minute drill here into the first half. St. Bonaventure does it so well. Spargo to Booker. And he's taken down after a nice game. And Spargo to Adam Gray Hayward. Hayward upfield. Moving the chains for the Seraphs. And back to Booker. Smart sophomore too, gonna get out of bounds, stop the clock. 28-14, and I've been telling you for years, Jerry, nothing runs like a Ford. Josh Ford, 2-point conversion, 30-14 Seraphs. And the icing on the cake, Lorenzo Booker. Had over 100 yards rushing, and too bad receiving the ball either. 38 yards for the touchdown. Seraphs win, final score 37-20. Cardinals hosting Division 11 powerhouse St. Bonaventure. For more on the game, we check in with Friday Football Focus reporter Scott Hennessy, who is live from our Ventura County Bureau. Scott?
All right, thanks a lot, Mike. Well, the St. Bonaventure Seraphs enter tonight's contest with the top-ranked offense and defense in all of Ventura County. The Seraphs are scoring over 42 points a game while surrendering just barely 7 points per contest, quite a margin of victory. More Mascaro now. He rubs off a couple of blocks and plays Twister with the Cardinal defense here for 14 more. That made things easy for the man of the night. Fellow sophomore Lorenzo Booker hits Pater from 5 yards out. 2-point try was no good. 6-0 Seraphs early. It didn't take Booker long to find the end zone. His second touchdown run comes from 24 yards out to put the Seraphs up 15-0. Late in the first quarter now, Santa Paula turns it over all night. On Santa Paula. Took St. Bonnie all of 3 plays to punch it in. Booker gets his third touchdown of the game with this short run, 22-0. St. Bonnie in the lead. Now, this is not going to be an instant replay here, folks. It's just another touchdown for Booker. His fourth of the game, 29-0 Seraphs. Lorenzo, I hope you're watching tonight because we've assembled a nice highlight reel for you. With his road jersey still a pristine white, barely a grass stain to speak of, he goes 45 yards for his fifth touchdown. Look at his blockers following him all the way down the field. Two schools cheerleaders, they're harmonious at halftime, and there's some sweet defensive music on this hit by Isaiah Bridges. Oh my God, I've seen that 10 times and it still sends a chill up my back. You ready for this now? Booker is gonna score his sixth touchdown of the game just a couple minutes into the third quarter. You heard me right, folks, 6 touchdowns, 43-0 at this point. Lorenzo decided to finally give someone else a chance. He lets his buddy Mascaro cap the scoring off at 50, and that's gonna wrap it up, 50-0. St. Bonaventure goes on to win this game.
Last year's Tri-Valley League champs, St. Bonaventure's Seraphs, are not just winning games this season, they are destroying teams. Tonight, the Seraphs coming up to Santa Barbara to face Bishop Diego. For more on the game, we check in with the King, live in the newsroom, Chris King. It's always better to be live than dead from the newsroom, right, Chris?
I couldn't agree more with you, Mike. In their last two games, these numbers are actually kind of silly. The Seraphs have won by a combined score of 88-0. His next possession, Michael Spargo finds Brandon Mascoro for a 25-yard gain. Mascoro refusing to go down. Next play, Lorenzo Booker. This guy is fast. He picks up 15 more yards right here. There he is on the right side of your screen. A couple plays later, I told you he was fast. Booker with a 20-yard touchdown run. St. Bonnie gets the 2-point conversion to go up 15-0. Final score in this one, 42-0 Seraphs. St. Bonaventure moves to 2-0 in the Tri-Valley League. Playing the St. Bonaventure Seraphs have another impressive streak going. Coming into last night's game against Carpinteria, St. Bonaventure has shut out their last 4 opponents. Unbelievable. Let's head to Larrabee Stadium. First quarter here, St. Bonnie trying to get on the board first. Check out the effort by Adam Gray Hayward. Yeah, do it. Second quarter now, St. Bonnie's next possession, Lorenzo Booker. 23 yards for the score, 16-0 St. Bonnie after this one. Let's check out those Bears again. Oh, so good. Final score, 41-14 St. Bonnie. Gray Hayward finishes with 4 touchdowns and 162 yards on only 7 receptions.
The St. Bonaventure Seraphs enter tonight's action 7-0, ranked 2nd in the latest CIF Division 11 polls. What makes this accomplishment even more impressive? Head coach John Mack starts 8 sophomores.
8 has not only been enough for the St. Bonaventure Seraphs, it has been perfect. 8 sophomore starters, Lorenzo, Brandon, James, Mike, Luis, John, Matt, and David, have helped the Seraphs to a 7-0 record.
Generally, we'll give guys an opportunity to play, and we don't care what grade they're in. If they're the best players, they play for us. To have 8 is unique.
Talk about unique. This group does not lose, ever. They went 10-0 last year playing on the junior varsity team. Leading the Elite 8 this season, running back Lorenzo Booker. The super sophomore has already broken the school's single-game rushing record, and oh yeah, he is leading Ventura County in rushing yards with over 1,200.
Number one is his work ethic. His works as hard or harder than anybody on the team. But the other thing is his unselfish attitude. He's the first to credit the offensive line.
My gosh, oh my gosh. I mean, every time you go through a hole, there's like holes you could drive a truck through, you know. Personally, I think my offensive line is the greatest in the county.
One of those great linemen is sophomore James Bonelli. He checks in at 6'5", 260 pounds. He's only 15 years old.
Yeah. Ate a lot when I was little. Ate my vegetables.
Now only one Seraph starts on both offense and defense. And it is not a senior. It's not a junior. It's sophomore Brandon Mascaro.
He's our free safety and a receiver. And he's doing the same thing on defense that Lorenzo brings to the offense. So with those two young guys, we feel real good about the future.
And they feel good about the present, where these fabulous 15-year-olds are hoping to win a CIF Varsity Football Championship before they even get their driver's license.
All right, tonight those 8 sophomores and the rest of the St. Bonaventure Seraphs playing at Fillmore tonight. Now watch this. I did a story on Lorenzo Booker, and now he's trying to hit me. He comes around the corner, and Lorenzo is going to hit me.
Whoa!
Goodness. But there was a clip, so it was a touchdown.
Yeah, the referee's in your back pocket.
There you go. Now that made 3rd and 22. Michael Spargo to Whitney Lewis. All right, the sophomores, he's a freshman. He says, hey, do a piece on the freshman. Goodness. John Mack goes right back to Booker, and he's got the touchdown, 28-0, St. Bonaventure. And 49-0. St. Bonaventure now 8-0 for the season, 3-0 in league. All right, now to St. Bonaventure. Perfection, 14 games, 14 wins. That is what John Mack, St. Bonaventure Seraphs achieved last year on their way to a Division 11 CIF championship. Considering that the Seraphs started 8 sophomores last season, the Seraphs are the overwhelming favorites to win another title this year. St. Bonaventure opening the 2000 campaign against Paraclete, who won the Division 12 CIF championship last year. Double trouble for opponents this year. On the left, Lorenzo Booker. On the right, Whitney Lewis. First play from scrimmage. Quarterback Jack Swisher to Whitney Lewis. 75 yards for the touchdown. 2-point conversion was good. 15 seconds into the game, it's 8-0 Seraphs. Second possession, Swisher to Lewis. Lewis played a little bit last year as a freshman. This was his coming out game. Takes it to the 10-yard line. 2 plays later, Lorenzo Booker, 1 yard for the touchdown. 2-point conversion, good. 16-0. Tim Gutierrez just draws up another play. Final play of the first quarter, Lorenzo Booker. So tough. Lorenzo Booker's Gio, and he's gone with a win. 78 yards on the screen pass for the touchdown. 2-point conversion was good, so after one, it was over. It was 24-0, but we got a lot more highlights. Lorenzo Booker, short touchdown run. Conversion failed. It was 30-0. St. Bonaventure, still in the second quarter, mind you, Jerry. Lorenzo Booker, spectacular run, spectacular player. Oh, he cuts, he slices, he dices, 47 yards for the apparent touchdown, but it was holding. Brought it back. And at halftime, John Mack Seraphs leads 37-0. Third quarter action, Swisher, Whitney Lewis, over 170 yards receiving, 2 touchdowns. And look how Whitney Lewis and Booker celebrate, like the old Chicago Bears, like the late Walter Payton there, 44-0. And that's the way the game ended. Final score, 51-0. The Seraphs now will take their 15-game winning streak into next Saturday's home game against Crespi out of the San Fernando Valley. Back in week one, the defending Division 11 CIF champion St. Bonaventure Seraphs dismantled Division 12 school Paraclete 51-0. This week, the Seraphs on the road facing another D12 school, Notre Dame of Riverside. I learned that Riverside not very close to Santa Barbara, Jerry. First quarter, Lorenzo Booker and his G-O-N-E gone with the win. 95 yards for the touchdown. Booker over 200 yards in this game. He's got over 3,000 yards in his career. He's only played through his third game of his junior season. Yes, he is a talent, 6-0 Sarah. Third quarter, Lorenzo Booker. The counter to the right, and Lorenzo's in the end zone. Diving right at me, but thankfully he didn't hit me. Remember last week?
Oh, yes.
St. Bonaventure goes on to win this game. Final score 28-14, so not the blowout we thought, but still another St. Bonaventure win. Dating back to last year, Seraphs have now won 17 straight games. They're at St. Joseph of Santa Maria next Friday night. All right, the numbers tell you just how dominant St. Bonaventure has been in high school football over the last 4 years. The Seraphs have won 4 straight Tri-Valley League titles, 2 CIF championships, and they are riding a Ventura County record 20-game winning streak. Tonight, the Seraphs playing at a very solid Oak Park school. Oak Park down 8-0 in the first quarter, but Josh Walker to Chad Kesser. Big yardage for the Eagles, and Eric Teston. Teston up the middle, inside the St. Bonaventure 10, but the full Monty, not tonight against Bonnie. The field goal is missed, and it's 8-0 still. Saris, Lorenzo Booker. You saw Tyler Ebell earlier in the show. Lorenzo, well, they're waging quite a war, aren't they? How about the moves? See you later. 80 yards for the touchdown. 2-point conversion failed. 14-0 Seraphs. Booker just warming up, folks. Defense now for the Seraphs. Bobby Atani, the interception. And the quarter ended with St. Bonaventure up 14-0 after one. Second quarter, Lorenzo Booker, 1 yard touchdown run, 21-0 Seraphs. You play St. Bonaventure, you have to play a perfect game. You still might not win, and you can't have these mistakes. On a punt, Oak Park touches the football. And the fumble is recovered. It's not a touchdown. Can't advance that one. But Lorenzo Booker's advancing the ball. 3 yards for the touchdown. And then the swinging gate, 2-point conversion. Booker wide open. 29-0 Seraphs. But wait, there's still more. Lorenzo Booker, the fake reverse. He's got it. And he's GONE. Gone with the win. 93 yards for the touchdown. How about this line on Booker? 12 carries, 272 yards. 6 touchdowns. Amazing. Seraphs are amazing. They win it final 50-0. So the Seraphs are now 7-0 for the season, 1-0 in league to the Tri-Valley League, where St. Bonaventure has not only won a Ventura County record 21 straight games, but they have not lost a league contest since Bishop Diego beat them back in 1995. Bishop just happened to be this week's opponent. First quarter, trailing 8-0, Bishop's Dave Elmerich. Elmerich almost busted all the way, 50 yards before the kicker. And Lorenzo Booker, right, he's always going places. And a 20 yards for a Seraphs first down. And quarterback Jack Swisher, sounds like he should be playing basketball with a last name like Swisher. He says, forget the three-pointer, I got 6 points here. Quarter, Lorenzo Booker has some nice runs, but he's yet to score. Oh, he takes care of that right here. Lorenzo Booker over 100 yards rushing on just 11 carries. Seraphs roll. Final score 47-0. They moved to 8-0 for the year, 2-0 in league. Going back to last year, in their last 6 league games, the Seraphs have outscored their opponents over 200-14.
Welcome back to Friday Football Focus. Now, it is not uncommon for a team to shut out another team, but St. Bonaventure was going for a league shutout tonight. In 3 Tri-Valley League games, the Seraphs had not allowed a single point. Could Carpinteria find the scoreboard against mighty St. Bonnie tonight? Well, first quarter, Seraphs quarterback Jack Swisher goes in from 9 yards out, and then they go for the 2-point conversion. And what a catch this is by Whitney Lewis. Get it back, though, after forcing a punt, and superstar running back Lorenzo Booker. This is one of the nicest runs you will see all year long. That is 44 yards to the Carpinteria 12-yard line. Just a series of phenomenal moves. Second quarter now, same drive. Booker goes in from 5 yards out, made it 14-0. St. Bonaventure would force a punt. So St. Bonnie back on offense. Booker, like he shot out of a cannon, just flying past everyone. He flew past Scott Lopez there. And folks, Scott Lopez is fast. 66-yard touchdown. And Coley Candell wondering what they can do to stop one of the state's best running backs. Well, here's Gokong back on offense to Scott Lopez, who ran a nice route and a nice diving catch, but the Warriors' drive stalled, so Seraphs get it back. Swisher to Brandon Mascaro, 44 yards, a great catch by Brandon, deep into Carpinteria territory. And one more time from Lorenzo Booker, 18-yard touchdown run, his third TD of the first half, 28-0 St. Bonnie. And we want to show you one more big hit from this game. These two teams were so physical tonight. Watch Chris Gokong just level the defenders there. Wow. Final score in this one, 35-3. So Carpinteria kicked a field goal on the final play to be the only team in the Tri-Valley League this season to score against the Seraphs.
Top team in Division 11, St. Bonaventure, making a long bus ride to Westminster High School to face Calvary Chapel. St. Bonaventure riding a 25-game winning streak, and most expected them to add another win to that total tonight. Opening kickoff, St. Bonaventure's Jashawn McCowan takes it, and he heads upfield, finds a seam, and he's down at the midfield. Then the Seraphs, Lorenzo Booker, 13 yards up the field. They actually tackled him there. Booker up, over, and yes, he is in. Two-point conversion good, 8-0 Seraphs. And for the score, two-point conversion good, 16-0 Seraphs. It's just 9:37, still in the first quarter. Then Lorenzo Booker. Are we lucky to have this guy week in and week out? Lorenzo Booker, 61 yards, just Sunday stroll for Booker. Two-point conversion good. It was 24-0, and the Seraphs scored a lot more than that. Final score, 73-7. I think John Mack was making a statement tonight. Seraphs moved to 12-0 for the season. The defending CIF Division 11 champion Seraphs move into the semifinals, where they will square off against Carpinteria, a team they beat in Week 10. 30
extended their Ventura County record winning streak to 29 games last week with an impressive victory at Dos Palos up in the Fresno area. Today, the Seraphs travel into San Diego to face Marcus Allen's old school, Lincoln. And oh, is this guy going to be the next Marcus Allen? Lorenzo Booker. Late second quarter, 1 yard touchdown run, 31-6 Seraphs in the second quarter. That was mid second. Booker on the night, 4 touchdowns, 128 yards rushing. Nice moves there. And with the game out of hand, Jack Swisher out, Davis in, touchdown pass to Whitney Lewis. Seraphs win again. Final score, 51-18. The 2-0 Seraphs have the ultimate test this coming Thursday when they host Division III power Hart. While most high schools were able to play their games last week, St. Bonaventure's game with Hart was canceled after a strong recommendation to do so from the Los Angeles Archdiocese. This week, the Seraphs had to let go of their disappointment about not facing powerhouse Hart and get focused on facing Notre Dame of Riverside.
Hey, I just want to let you know this is the best 1-2 combination in the county.
Number 1, Lorenzo Booker, and number 4, Whitney Lewis, backed up their words against Notre Dame. Back on offense, superstar Lorenzo Booker comes up with one of the best 36-yard runs that you will ever see. Tom Delperdang has Booker wrapped up, but Lorenzo, so tough, breaks the tackle, and Lorenzo takes the ball down to the 5-yard line.
You know, I just kept my legs going. That's something that I tried to work on each year because obviously I'm pretty good at making people miss. So, you know, I tried to work on my strength and all my hard work paid off on that run. Unfortunately, I didn't get in the end zone though.
Not to worry. The very next play, Booker takes the pitch and gets into the end zone. Once again, the two-point conversion was good. 16-0, Seraphs lead. Seraphs went into halftime up 31-0. The first time Lorenzo Booker touched the ball in the second half, he went 26 yards for the touchdown. He later added his third rushing touchdown on the night. For the game, Booker had 165 yards on the ground in just 11 carries. The Seraphs finished off their 58-0 victory with a touchdown run by reserve Joe Wario.
And it was real fitting. He was our practice player of the week this past week. And just gives you all his all. He's got to imitate the best player on the opposing team every week. And you saw how the whole team was excited for him. I had the whole stadium erupted, you know. It's just great to see Joe Wario get in the end zone there.
With the victory, the Seraphs moved to 3-0 for the season and have scored 137 points this year.
Extend their county record winning streak to 31 games, and I think Booker and Lewis are the best 1-2 punch in the county, maybe the state.
No question with at least the county, Mike. And I'll tell you what John Mack said in some of those comments that you got from him, that they do have some things to work on. You beat somebody 58-0, and I think the only thing you have to work on, Coach, is getting a new ball bag.
Yeah.
That's it. What?
When St. Bonaventure completed their second straight 14-0 season last year, the Seraphs trailed only one time at the half. That was up in Santa Maria against St. Joseph's. The Seraphs rallied to win that game 44-22. This year, the two teams met at Larrabee Stadium in Ventura.
The midfield handshake was as close as St. Joseph got to mighty St. Bonaventure all night. The Seraphs scored on the opening drive of the game on this 25-yard scamper by senior Lorenzo Booker.
So, I mean, to come out on that first drive and to put points on the board, you know, it was basically execute.
When St. Joseph got the ball, Dustin Kelly was sacked by Warren Anderson and Jed Bednarski. Kelly fumbles the football and the Seraphs pounce on it. A few plays later, Booker is back in the end zone, this time on a 6-yarder. Seraphs up quickly, 14-0. Next Seraphs possession, it's Jack Swisher to Luis Lopez for the touch, and the route is on. Lorenzo Booker's third touchdown of the game makes it 29-0 Seraphs after one quarter. Second quarter now, Lorenzo Booker, you do nice work. This is vintage Booker. He cuts it back and goes across the field for a 19-yard touchdown run, 36-0 Seraphs lead.
I kind of felt that they was waiting on my cutback a little bit, and I talked to our defensive back coach about that earlier. Number three was waiting for the cutback, so I kind of stretched it a little bit to begin with, and then, you know, I made the cutback wide open, and that's why it worked so well down there.
Again, the Seraphs have the answer. Lorenzo Booker's only carry of the second half is a good one. He goes 79 yards for the touchdown. On the night, Booker scores 5 TDs and runs for 220 yards on just 14 carries.
His number one concern is winning games. It's unfortunate he doesn't get the carries that he really deserves. And we're not going to do anything to embarrass our opponent.
After Booker's last TD, St. Bonaventure's Matt White picks off this pass and takes it to the house. The Seraphs go on to win it, going away 76-12.
The Seraphs still have not lost a football game since 1998. That's a string of 32 consecutive wins. St. Bonaventure plays next Saturday at Harvard Westlake. For St. Joseph's, they will bring their 2-2 record to Arroyo Grande to play the Eagles next Friday. One is supposed to be the loneliest number, but St. Bonaventure's senior Lorenzo Booker is getting plenty of attention. He is rated as the number one prep running back in the nation. There is one category that Booker is not number one, and that is losing. Entering this week, Booker had played in 35 varsity football games. He has not once tasted defeat.
And my new anthem is that new song by Nelly, you know, number one. You got to be number one. You know, two's not a winner, three nobody remembers.
Nobody will forget how St. Bonaventure's Seraph Lorenzo Booker burst onto the high school football scene in 1999. As a sophomore, he led Ventura County with over 2,500 rushing yards, and the Seraphs went 14-0 and won a CIF championship. Despite the success, Lorenzo and the coaching staff wanted more.
After his sophomore year, we felt like the thing he needed to work on was his breakaway speed and his getting long touchdown runs, get the attention of the scouts by breaking those long ones. And he went on 2 over 80 and 1 over 90 and, had a fair share of long touchdown runs.
Booker followed up that sensational season by rushing for over 3,000 yards as a junior. Once again, the Seraphs won a CIF championship and finished 14-0. But once again, Lorenzo went back to work.
It wasn't enough. You know, my ultimate goal was to go to college, you know, and right now I could go anywhere I want because of the 6 a.m.s and all the hard work in the weight rooms.
The 6 a.m. workouts paid off in San Diego as Booker was named the MVP of the prestigious Nike camp. With tons of yardage and a work ethic second to none, Lorenzo Booker has received scholarship offers from just about every top college program in the country.
I've actually narrowed it down to 9. I don't know how short of a list that is, but I mean, it's definitely a good problem, man. And to be honest, I haven't answered my phone in about a month.
Chances are you will not have to make an out-of-state call to reach Lorenzo at college. Booker is expected to choose between UCLA and USC.
You know, right now, UCLA is probably looking better than USC.
But for now, Booker is enjoying his senior year. He entered this week just 13 points shy of breaking California's all-time scoring record and just 922 yards away from being the state's all-time leading rusher. But it's the team record that most concerns Booker.
The state records, you know, I kind of knew I was going to have. So
I mean, we're going to go 42-0, you know, just because, you know, we have no doubt. There's no cockiness involved. It's just confidence.
The thing that it's great to see about him this year is the leadership qualities that are coming out, the development of some of the young guys and what he's done for the future of St. Bonaventure football.
Whether it's personal goals or team accomplishments, the man who wears number one always strives to be number one.
Mike, what a great piece and what a gifted athlete. And Lorenzo is very confident, but I think it's certainly worth noting that he is a very nice young man that is respectful of other people, always has a smile on his face and always says hello. He's very good to the ball boys on the sidelines.
Right, and he always credits his teammates, James Benelli opening up some big holes, Luis Lopez, the tight end.
Yeah, a lot of people might think he's arrogant or cocky. He's just very confident, but when it comes right down to it, he's a pretty nice guy with a $1 million smile. Lorenzo and the rest of his undefeated St. Bonaventure Seraphs playing in Santa Barbara tonight as they face the Bishop Diego Cardinals at Santa Barbara City College. Could Bishop pull off the upset of the millennium? Well, St. Bonnie in the first quarter. Lorenzo Booker, watch this run. Just bouncing to the outside. Here comes a move. Cuts it back to the inside. Inside the 25-yard line of Bishop Diego. And then Jack Swisher to Louis Lopez. Big Louis takes a big pop there, but that gets it inside the 20. Two plays later, Booker pounds it in for a touchdown. The conversion failed, so it's 6-0 St. Bonaventure. Lorenzo Booker breaks a tackle. This is the play of the night. He broke two tackles in that little crowd of red jerseys, and he is gone. That is a touchdown down the left sideline. Extra point, no good. 12-0 St. Bonnie. Now St. Bonnie's D. Terrell Lambert is going to sack J.D. Dunn. Look at old J.D. Just got him by the foot there, and he goes down. So St. Bonaventure holds. They get the ball back. Jack Swisher to Whitney Lewis. What a play this is. Whitney took a pop right there, stayed on his feet, and watch this. On the St. Bonnie sideline, they just said he jumped too high because his feet were moving when he came down. So he's down, but nonetheless, that's 52 yards on the play. Same drive, second quarter now. Swisher to Lewis for the touchdown. Great catch in the back of the end zone and an excellent pass. How about history? The two-point conversion here by Lorenzo Booker. He becomes California's all-time high school football scoring leader. And he got the ball after the game. Congratulations to you, Lorenzo. Bishop Diego got it back. Cavaletto hauls in the J.D. Dunn pass and gets inside the 5-yard line. Next play, Aaron Sanchez is going to go in from 3 yards out for the touchdown. The extra point good. It was 20-7, St. Bonaventure. Now, with about 3 minutes left to go in the half, St. Bonnie going back to work. It is Jack Swisher to Whitney Lewis for the touchdown. The extra point was good, and the final score in this one, all St. Bonnie, 51-7. So St. Bonaventure runs its Ventura County record winning streak to 36 games. They are 8-0 this year and 2-0 in league for Bishop D.
The St. Bonaventure Seraphs will move to Division 4 next year, so this week marked their final regular season game in Division 11. Seraphs, who have not lost a game since 1998, were going for their sixth Tri-Valley League championship in a row, standing in their way. Coley Candell's Carpinteria Warriors, this contest being played down in Moore Park High School. First possession of the game for St. Bonaventure. First play, Lorenzo Booker, G-O-N-E. Gone with the win. Not only goes 70 yards for the touchdown, but this run, he becomes Ventura County's all-time career rushing leader, passing a couple guys like UCLA's Tyler Ebell and Ronnie Jenkins, who plays for the San Diego Chargers. Congratulations, Lorenzo Booker, over 7,600 career yards and counting. Two-point conversion good, 8-0. Next, St. Bonaventure possession. It's the Trent Dilfer of high school football, Jack Swisher. He gets no credit. All he does is win games. Jack Swisher to Whitney Lewis, 40 yards for the touchdown. Two-point conversion failed, 14-0 Seraphs. Takeover on downs, Lorenzo Booker. See you later. This time he goes 66 yards for the touchdown. Oh, by the way, Lorenzo's in Tallahassee, Florida this weekend on a recruiting trip to see Bobby Bowden, Florida State. Two-point conversion good, 22-0 Seraphs. And one thing you can't do against St. Bonaventure, turn the football over. Carp with some issues. David Reyes picks it up. And very next play, I wonder who you're going to give it to. Probably Zoe. Lorenzo Booker, 17 yards for the touchdown. Oh, by the way, he has a new California State touchdown record. Over 100 and almost 20, I think. Two-point conversion, 30-0. And then Carp, Swisher to Brandon Mascoro.
So easy. 37-0 Saris at the half. Now, third quarter started, and, well, I was kind of talking to some people, and, well, ensuing kickoff. Oh, there's Whitney Lewis. Come on, Clanny. He's going 95 yards for the touchdown. I promise, Whit, you run one back in the playoffs, I'll get it from start to finish. 44-0 Saris. St. Bonnie wins. Final 47-0 Saris end up 4-0 in league, 10-0 for the season. Oh, by the way, the JV team also went to. Now to Division 11, where the most dominant team remains St. Bonaventure from Ventura and the two-time defending CIF champion Saris opening up at home versus Calabasas. Now, back in 1997, Calabasas upset the Saris in an opening round postseason game. To do it again, Coyotes would have to put an end to the Saris' 38-game winning streak. First possession of the game for St. Bonaventure. You know who, Lorenzo Booker, touchdown. Two-point conversion failed, 6-0. Calabasas had their first possession picked off by Brandon Mascoro and their second by Mascoro. A few plays later, Whitney Lewis playing a lot of running back. And Lewis pulls his way in. Two-point conversion failed, 12-0 Saris. Third possession of the game for St. Bonaventure looked like the second possession with Lewis running it in for the touchdown. Only thing the Saris weren't doing is getting the two-point conversion. They led 18-0. Still in the first, Lorenzo Booker. A great move, and this guy really sets up his blocks as well. 46 yards for the touchdown. Saris finally gets smart. They use Mike Barrows, an excellent kicker, to kick the extra point, 25-0. Saris, and in some history, Lorenzo Booker, G-O-N-A, gone with the win. Not only a 55-yard touchdown, but that run breaks California's career rushing mark. Booker now 7,826 yards. In the game, Booker, 11 carries, 188 yards, 4 touchdowns, 32-0 Saris. We're still in the first. This is Luis Lopez taking the short pass from Jack Swisher. Lopez usually blocks for Booker, so now I'm making the highlights here. And no one's happier than Papa Lopez. Yeah, 39-0 Saris. He's actually scored 2 touchdowns against St. Bonaventure. Justin Finchel to Nick Berard, and oh, Nick, great effort to get in there. It was 60-13 at that point in the second. Ensuing kickoff, who in the world is Andres Thomas? I see a lot of Saris games, I've never seen this guy. Oh, Andres Thomas going down touchdown alley, 97 yards. How many weapons do they have? It was 67-13 at the half. Saris win it with a team record 80 points, final score 80-13. Saris are now 11-0 over the year. They extend their Ventura County record winning streak to 39 games. They will face Verbum Day next week.